So here's what happened. I spent the night at KOA because I'm traveling from Tennessee and I'm heading out to Arizona. I wanted to be there on time for the RTR, but it's the 11th right now, so it looks like I'll be there in about a week. I don't need to be there for the whole 14 days. Going to Arizona where it's warm because it's 13 degrees here. And I'm about to show you what I just went through and what lesson I learned by making mistakes because I seem to do that. So anyway, I made a video about what not to do when it's 13 below zero. No, it's 13, just 13 degrees, not below zero. And what not to do with your plugins. So let's go watch the video right now. You know, as hard as I try, I have to learn so many things the hard way. Not everything. You know, sometimes people tell you about things that are so simple to them, they forget to tell you. And I'm going to show you what I mean right now. I'm at a KOA park. It's Cheyenne Gift Shop. It's about Cheyenne Indians. And then there's the KOA and nice little restaurant up there, but you can't see it because there's a hill in the way. But let me show you what my lesson is. Of course, now we're going into the sun. So you're probably guessing it. 13 degrees right now. And if you watched all those washing machine videos, you would have probably known about this. Got my heater on. Well, up in Canada when I was there, I bought this hose that they said does not freeze. Well, the hose might not freeze, but the water in it freezes. And so now, it's frozen. Everything is totally frozen inside this. A very expensive $51. I won't forget the price. $51. It's been in the sun. You can see my breath. 13 degrees. And I can't turn that faucet off to begin with. And I can't turn this thing because that's all frozen. Smart thing to do. No one ever told me. In fact, KOA should tell people this. But even worse than that, I mean, it's out in the sun, so actually it's not. I gotta move it over. Keep moving it to keep it in the sun. Something should defrost, I would think. This is in the sun. But guess what? When I washed my clothes yesterday, I didn't shut this up. And so the clothes water is now totally frozen in there, and the hose is totally frozen, full of water probably from the washing. And watch this move. Not frozen solid. Don't know what to do about that. I just leave it here, but I can't get it off of there. So I don't know what to do. It's frozen solid. So, I mean, I had to learn this lesson the hard way. Sometimes these simple things like that is left out of your knowledge of what to do. Even in Seward, Alaska, well, I didn't have hose hookup. And any place I did, I never had a problem. But then it is 13 degrees. I guess I should have thought of that. I don't know. But here's what I suggest. All you KOAs and RV parks need to tell people that if you hook up the sewer that you pay for, $42 a night, if you hook up the sewer and your water, chances are that you either need a heated hose, I found out. I didn't know about that even. You need a heated hose. Or you just unhook your water and use your fresh tank water. Fill up your fresh tank and at least you got a chance and you can drive off. I mean, everybody's gone now and I wanted to leave. It's a beautiful driving day. I wanted to get out here before the wind picks up again. So that's the lesson, hard lesson learned. I don't know what to do. I'll go up there and ask them if they got a hair dryer or something. I don't know what to do now. And then I'll be on my way. Lesson hard learned at the KOA. in Oklahoma, well, just past Oklahoma City, heading west. I had to stop here a few days because the wind was 52 miles an hour, gusts up to 52. It was scary on the road. But it's been a nice 2 days and got my clothes washed. At least they're not frozen. All right, I'll tell you what happens in the next video. And by the way, anyone watching up this far, I just wanted to let you know that I am putting together my Alaska trip as I make this trip. When I stop at night, I put it together. I thought I'd just do the entire trip, you know, maybe in one or a couple videos, even though I got like 40,000 pictures. I'm going to show you just the best parts so you don't have to listen to me go on and on and on and on. But I really had a wonderful trip. I'm not quite ready to put it up yet though. Okay, so this is my solution. And I went in, I talked to the people, and they said, well, we got a little tiny heater, but it was not working and it was smoking. And then I thought, wait, I got this thing for the dryer. If you watched the last video and you saw how I was drying my clothes, it was number 7, I believe, on that little washing machine thing. This is that heater that goes at the bottom and dries the clothes, and it's really hot. So it's already melting the water, and I can start to turn the water off there, but I'm not sure if it's all the way off. I'm gonna let it heat a little more. And then I plugged it into the 20. There's 220. Oh, my nose is running. Why does it run when it's so in the cold? Jeez. And so there. So the wash. I said it's just shower water. That's what I said. Anyway, and I left those things open. How can I be that dumb? I knew better than that, but I didn't think about the water in here freezing. Get that off. I don't care if I leave the hose here, but I got that heater. See, the my $100 heater on that. So we'll check that out and see what I can do. And of course, it's in the sun now. So this is my solution. I'll let you know if it works. Hello, so I'm about to take off now. I finished fixing everything. I have now lost and have to buy another. Ew, that looks gross. But I'm leaving that here. They said just leave it here. I finally am about ready to go. It's still cold, but it's been a couple hours now. So that took about 3 hours to solve that whole problem. And my hose is still frozen here. And I stuck it back here. It still got frozen water. So there you go, that is my adventure for today. And I'm off to go to Arizona where it's warm, where it's not 13, where it's probably like 70 right now. So here we go. Thanks for joining me on my learning experience. I just hope the videos that I make with my mistakes in them help someone else. That's why I do this. Otherwise, I'd just be showing some of my ignorance. But I still am a newbie. I've never actually plugged in my stuff in this freezing cold weather.